Hello ladies and gentlemen, so in this video I am discussing about phylum Hemichordata. In the Greek word, hemi means half. So let's see the characters of phylum Hemichordata. So the animals which are comes under the phylum Hemichordata are mostly marine in nature. So the first characters of phylum Hemichordata is it comprises of only marine animals. Then the body is soft, fragile, triploblastic and bilaterally symmetrical in nature. These animals which are comes under phylum Hemichordata is commonly called as tongworms, tongueworms, tongueworms. These are commonly called as tongueworms. Then the worm, the body of the worm is divided into or divisible into proboscis, collar and trunk in three parts. Proboscis, collar and trunk. The body like in the three parts, the worm like body is divisible into proboscis, collar and trunk. Then the fifth point is the notochord is called as stomochord. The notochord is called as stomochord. In the sixth point, the true pharyngeal gill seats are present. Here, in case of phylum Hemichordata, the true pharyngeal gill seats are present. Then comes to the nervous system. Then the seventh point, the nervous system is a network of nerve cells, fibers and embedded in the epidermis. This is the nervous system of phylum Hemichordata. So the nervous system is a network of nerve cell and fibers embedded in the epidermis. Then the circulatory system is open type with a dorsal heart. This is the circulatory system. Open type, as you know, the circulatory system is two type, open type and closed type. So in case of Hemichordata, the animals which are comes under phylum Hemichordata, they are open type with a dorsal heart. Then the ninth point is the excretion or the excretory system. The excretion occurs through single proboscis gland. Single proboscis gland or known as glomerulus. This is the excretion. Excretion occurs through single proboscis gland or glomerulus. Then the sexes. Sexes are separate. Male and female. Male, female are separate. Sexes are separate and fertilization is external. And the last point of the phylum Hemichordata is the development may be direct or through Toranaria larva. The development may be direct or through Toranaria larva, Toranaria larva, Toranaria, Toranaria larva. So the development may be direct or through Toranaria larva. And this phylum Hemichordata are nearly only 100 species. and the examples of phylum Hemichordata, the animals are Balanoglossus, Cephalodiscus are the examples of phylum Hemichordata. So Balanoglossus, 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 Balanoglossus and Cephalodiscus. So this is all about phylum Hemichordata and the characters of phylum Hemichordata. So thank you, friends. Thank you.